Okay, so we're going to move forward with our Shape Layer Accent Library. If you haven't seen the other two installments, I highly encourage you to check those out. We created a burst. It's the only burst you'll ever need, as well as some animated circles that you can bring into any project with the click of a button. And we'll be creating these animated shapes in the same way as we did those others, where all the effects and controls will be on one layer. We're going to save it as an animation preset, and I'm going to show you how you can use this in any number of projects. Right-click in this area to the left of our timeline and create a new shape layer. So open up this shape layer, add in a group, call this group Poly for Polystar. Within that, let's add in another group, and we're not going to name it just yet. We'll name that at some point. Add in our Polystar, and then we want to add in our stroke. Open up our Polystar path, change our type from a star to a polygon. All of these animations are going to be 1 second in length, so let's go to the 1 second mark, increase our outer radius to 400, and our stroke width, we're going to make that 0. Put keyframes on both of these values. Let's go back to the beginning of our animation, and now we want to make our outer radius 0 and our stroke width 50. Select all those keyframes, F9 to make those bezier, select these last two keyframes here, graph editor, and pull those handles all the way over. So you can make your opening stroke width any size you'd like, but it's good to go ahead and make that decision now because as we move forward, it will get buried. Take group 1, duplicate that, page down 1, 2, 3 times, pull these keyframes over, and the only thing we need to change is our outer radius. In the first instance, the ending value is 400, so let's make this 375. Control D to duplicate, page down 1, 2, 3 frames, move these keyframes over, go to the second set of keyframes, and now let's make this outer radius 350. This is going to be the foundation for all of our shape animations. So just going down, we'll rename this 1, 2, and 3. And this is really important as we start to move forward because we'll be adding some expression controls that are going to relate directly to the names of these groups. Add in a group. We're going to call this one circle. Add in that group like we did on our poly group. And then within that group, that's where we want to add in our ellipse and we want to give it a stroke. So again, this is going to be a 1 second animation. Now, the way their ellipses and rectangles scale, it's not quite the same as polygons. Our ending size on our polygon was 400. It doesn't quite match. Make this about 600. I'm going to hide my poly group for now. So let's put a keyframe for size at 600. And again, stroke width, let's make that 0. Let's go back to the beginning of our animation. I'm going to make our size 0. Our stroke width is going to be 50. So we want to select all those keyframes, F9 to make those bezier. Select this last group of keyframes, go to the graph editor, and let's just pull that over. So the animation that we get is this. Select group 1 here, duplicate that, page down 1, 2, 3. Let's grab our keyframes and move those down. Change the last value of this ellipse size. The first one ended at 600, let's make this one 550. Duplicate that group again, page down 1, 2, 3. Grab those keyframes. And then go to this last keyframe, and let's make this one 500. So let's close all this up. Add in a group, and we want to call this one RECT for rectangle. Within our rectangle group, add in another group. Within group 1, we're going to add in our rectangle, and we're going to add in our stroke. The 1 second mark, let's make our size 600 pixels, and then make our stroke width 0. Put keyframes for both of these values. Back to the beginning of our animation here, make our size 0, stroke width 50. So now select these keyframes, F9 to make those easy ease. Select these last two keyframes, go to our graph editor and pull the handle all the way to the left. Duplicate group 1, page down 1, 2, 3 times. Grab these keyframes, move them over, and now we just want to change our ending size from 600 to 550. Duplicate that group again. Go forward 3 frames. Let's grab all those and move those over. And we want to change this last value to 500. So I need to make sure I rename these groups. I may have missed this in our circle group. Let's go ahead and open that up. I did. So make sure that these are all named properly. So you want groups for poly, circle, and rectangle. And you want them all to be numbered 1, 2, 3, just like that. Turn on our circle group and our poly group. Okay, so I'll start to add in some expression controls so that way we can control things like color and which shape we'll be animating. First, let's add in a color control. Double-click that, and let's rename this to color 1. And then just duplicate this until we have colors 1, 2, and 3. we'll make our first color, we'll leave it white. Second color, maybe we'll make like this green. And then for the third color, I'm just going to do like a purple. Go to this finer toolbar and just type in color. Since we've named all of our groups, it's so much easier to link these up. 1, 2, 3. And we can close up our poly group. For circle group, we're going to do the same. So 1, 2, 3. Close up our circle group. We'll do our rectangle. Go 1, 2, 3. Now let's put in an expression control so that way we can choose which shape we want to animate. And the way we're going to do that is with our checkbox control. Let's call this one poly. Duplicate that. We'll call this one circle. Duplicate that. And I'm going to call this RECT for rectangle. Go to this finer toolbar and type in opacity. We're going to attach the opacity of our shape groups. So we're looking for the opacity of poly, circle, and RECT. So that's going to be this opacity setting right here. Take our pick whip for opacity on our poly group and attach it to our poly checkbox. Open up that expression, type times 100. Checkbox controls are binary. If the box is not checked, its code value is 0. If it is selected, its code value is 1. If this checkbox is off, we're going to take that value, 0, multiply it by 100, which is 0. If it's selected and it's on, then it's going to be 1 times 100. It's going to be turned on. And we're just going to do that for all of these. So take our opacity of our circle group, attach it to the checkbox, open that up, times 100. And then finally for our rectangle group, the opacity of that to the rectangle checkbox control and multiply that times 100. And as you can see, all of our shapes disappeared. If we click on poly, the polygons show up. If we click on circle, the circles show up, and same thing for rectangle. So that's a very useful expression, and whenever you're trying to turn something off and on, you can attach the opacity of a group or a layer or whatever it is you're trying to make an option to a checkbox control and just multiply it by 100. I'm going to focus on our poly group right here. You may want to have more than 5 sides, so we can add an expression control to control that as well. Let's go in here and add in a slider control. So make sure the layer is selected, double click slider control, and call this poly points. Go up to our finder again and type in points. And all of our points will show up. So we want all of our points to be the same. If our main polygon has 5 sides, we want them all to have 5 sides. So I'm going to reset this to 5 and just connect all of these points to this poly points slider control. Change this, make it 8. We can see now we have an octagon. If you want a triangle, you can do 3. A polygon has to have at least 3 sides. So if you make this value 0, it's still going to be a triangle. Also, same goes for 1 or for 2. So the lowest setting is going to be 3. You can change this now, and it will update on all these points. Okay, so now I want to focus on our rectangle group. So let's open this up. We can take this poly points slider control and just duplicate that. Rename this rect roundness, because you might want to control the roundness of your square. So go into our finder bar again and type in roundness. So we're not looking for the poly roundness. We want to make sure we're looking at the rectangle roundness. Connect all of these to this rectangle roundness. Now, since we duplicated it and we had the poly point set to 10, this rect roundness is set to 10. Uncheck our poly group and then check our rectangle group. We have that roundness. So these will all update. Okay, and I'm just going to move the poly points underneath the poly group there so that way those things are together. Type in point control and I'm going to call that position. I want to add in another slider control. Double click that. Rename that to scale. Add in an angle control. I'm going to call that rotation. Press P for position. Holding down shift, click S and R to bring up position, scale, rotation. Attach these values. Now our scale, you can see, is set to 100. So before I attach our scale, notice our slider control is set to 0. So if I attach that without making any changes, it's going to disappear. Just change your scale to 100. And then rotation to our angle control. If we change this to 45 degrees, we have diamonds. Take off that roundness. Just have a whole different kind of animation. So now we can save this as an animation preset the way we've been doing in our other tutorials. Select Contents, Effect, and Transform. Go up to Animation, Save Animation Preset. This will bring you to your documents, Adobe version. I'm in 2023, user presets, and I have a bunch of folders. So I'm going to go into my 7-Minute AE folder, and I created the Shape Layer Accent Library folder. Rename this Animated Shapes. So now we can get rid of that layer, go to our effects and presets, animation presets, user presets, and it's right here. Double click on animated shapes, hit U to bring up our keyframes, and as you can see, everything came back in. The reason why this is such a powerful way to create these accents is that you have complete control over these. This is the third tutorial where I've shown you how to make some shape layer accents. Take the ones we've already created and start to experiment with them. I highly encourage you to mess around with some of these and see what you can come up with. Start to include them in your own infographics and stay tuned because we'll be doing more of these in the coming weeks. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.